In this episode, we're going to talk about injection molding. What if your invention idea involves an injection mold? Is this something that you should pursue? Injection molded products are actually quite interesting for the inventor. That's because the cost of the mold is the only real expense. Once the mold is made, the parts are actually cheap that come out of the mold. So inventors often look at this as a solution for their first invention. I'm going to talk a little bit about the pros and cons of injection molds. If you like what you've been learning so far, please be sure to subscribe, give me a thumbs up, and leave some comments below. If you look here, this is actually an injection molded part that I designed. It's a little thumb knob that goes onto a nut. So if you take a nut and then press it in, if it would go in, if you take the nut and you press it into the plastic thumb knob, you can now use it to turn onto something. It's actually, I think it's a pretty cool part. Now, the mold itself probably costs less than $1,000 to make. Obviously, you don't make a mold with one of them in it. We have multiple cavities in the mold to produce the same part many times. That way, it was quicker to make large quantities. I use this product on my Sonic Levitator. I think you've seen that in a few of the videos before.
This is the Sonic Levitation Machine.
Acoustic levitation is accomplished by transmitting high-pressure sound waves through the air and then trapping objects within those waves.
The Sonic Levitation Machine's powerful transducer projects sound waves toward the reflector. Objects can be held in place between the nodes and anti-nodes of the source and reflected waves.
I invented this product as a fun way to experiment. But back to this. So this simple little plastic injection part is an example of something that you can make. Now, I wouldn't suggest this as being your first invention, but you know, I've thought about making this available in moldable sizes because it's so neat because it snaps onto nuts and also bolts and turns them into thumb screws. But let's get a little bit more serious about some more complicated injection molded parts. I knew a guy that made a camera brace for skateboarders. It's actually quite popular. You've probably seen it. It's sort of a U-shaped plastic brace that you hold like this. The camera goes underneath, and skateboarders use it to stabilize their cameras as they're filming, you know, other guys on skateboards. Now, I remember when he made this product, it was very popular in the beginning. I think it retailed for $29 or $39. So a lot of kids bought these things. This was quite a few years ago. The problem was within about a year, the mold had already been ripped off and somebody was selling it cheaper all over the internet. Now the question is, could this person have gotten a patent for it? No, not really. They could have patented the shape and that would have protected them. The overall design, they could have got a design patent to protect themselves. But the reality of it is, for what he was making on it to fight the legal fees, it would have gone nowhere, so it wasn't worth it. Again, I talk about this, being first in is most important. So if you're thinking about injection molds, you're definitely going to have to be the first in the market. That's not to say that injection molds aren't an important part of the invention process, because we use injection molds for other things too. They're not just an entire product. We also use them for cases in our electronics and also accessories to like our aluminum parts that we machine. It just depends on what you're designing. So injection molds might be required for your invention, regardless of what it is. In future videos, I am going to show you how to design some simple parts using injection molds. I think it's an important skill to have, and there are some tricks you'll need to understand when designing your injection mold, and it'll really help if you know how to do it on your own. So look for those SolidWorks training videos that are coming in the future. There's also a bunch of them already on here. One is specifically about injection molds, so you may want to check that one out.